By now, you have likely heard about Barbie Hsu, fondly known as Star S to many of us, passing away at 48 years old due to flu-related pneumonia. Now, if you are confused about why this could happen to a 48-year-old or are getting worried, watch on because I'm going to simplify everything and also debunk some misconceptions about the flu and pneumonia. For a start, the flu is basically just a short form for influenza, so note that they are not different things. So from now on, I'll use the word flu instead. Before anything, you need to know this. This is obviously not medical advice, and I'm not kidding when I say this. Never seek medical advice from the internet, because Dr. Google is the worst doctor in the world. Instead, if you are sick or feeling unwell, seek medical attention from a real doctor. Singapore has one of the best medical systems in the world, so just trust whatever a doctor says instead of believing what Google or ChatGPT say. So, what is the flu? Simply put, the flu is a viral infection caused by the influenza virus, which affects the nose, throat, and sometimes the lungs. Note the word viral. This means it's caused by a virus, not bacteria. For healthy people, it's usually not serious and they can recover within a week as the immune system clears out the virus. Even if you visit a GP, the GP will likely prescribe medication that makes you feel better but doesn't actually fight the virus, as your immune system usually destroys the virus on its own. In fact, sometimes we might have the flu without even knowing, as our body clears the virus quickly. It's caused by the flu virus, which has been living with us for perhaps billions of years. However, here's the first misconception. The flu is not serious and therefore won't kill us. That is completely untrue. You see, the WHO estimates that there are 290,000 to 650,000 influenza-related respiratory deaths annually around the world, with a higher mortality rate in less developed regions. However, it mainly affects people who are 65 years old and above, with them contributing to up to 85% of the deaths. Nevertheless, while it's rare for a healthy adult to die from the flu, it is still possible. But what is flu-related pneumonia? Usually, the flu virus just affects our nose and throat, which is why we get a sore throat and runny nose. However, sometimes the virus can enter the lungs, causing a lung infection. Nevertheless, the flu virus usually just attacks our nose and throat, which isn't that serious. It can be slightly more serious when the virus gets into our lungs. This is why when you visit a GP, they will use a stethoscope and ask you to breathe in and out. They are trying to listen to your lungs to check for any infection. There's another way that the flu can cause pneumonia. The flu virus might damage parts of your throat, allowing bacteria to enter the lungs, causing a bacterial lung infection, which is also called pneumonia, since pneumonia is basically any lung infection. Simply put, you can say that the flu opens the door for a deadlier bacteria to enter the lungs and infect them. Called post-influenza bacterial pneumonia, it's usually one of the leading causes of death for severe flu cases. It's unknown whether this was what affected TARS, but nevertheless, you can see that while the flu is generally harmless, it can still be serious. This is why it's important to get your vaccines. There are vaccines for both the flu and pneumonia. You see, you cannot just get the flu vaccine because remember, post-influenza bacterial pneumonia is caused by bacteria. Therefore, it's recommended that you get both the flu vaccine and the pneumonia vaccine, which is known as the pneumococcal vaccine. For people 18 to 64, you should take it if you have a chronic condition like diabetes or any condition that weakens your immune system. People who are 65 and above should take it regardless of their health condition. If you are a Singaporean with a chronic condition or are 65 and above and have enrolled in a healthier SG clinic, it's completely free. There's another way to fight the flu and pneumonia. Remember I mentioned the immune system a lot? If you have a strong immune system, you can fight them off easily. But here's the thing, do not believe any live streamers on Facebook or TikTok selling supplements that claim to improve your immune system. I repeat again, do not believe any medical advice from any live streamers. Please, tell your parents that. Instead, if you want to improve your immune system, sleep more, exercise more, and eat healthier. Or just ask your doctor, who will likely also tell you not to believe those live streamers. Now, if there's anything you need to take away from this video, it's this. Take your vaccines if you can, and lead a healthy lifestyle. Watch this video on how to have a healthy diet. And thank you for spending almost 4 minutes with me. I really appreciate it.